You see how judges do? It's just bullshit, 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 bullshit. If a judge is talking, they're lying or manipulating. Period. Period. You guys are getting creamed, destroyed, annihilated by a guy who was so clueless as to the law about a month ago, a month prior to this, that he allowed himself to get arrested because he didn't even recognize the legalese and what a cop was saying to arrest him. Otherwise, he never would have done it. He did not go to the airport looking to get arrested. He went to the airport not looking to get molested by TSA. And then they took away the option for the metal wand scanner, and he said he wanted that anyway, and they said, no, leave the metal wand. And he said, no, I want the metal wand scanner, and boom, you're arrested. And he goes from that to kicking this judge's ass in a month. A month. Is this sinking in? Zero to kicking judicial ass in a month. There are several people, along with myself, who can turn that kind of result out of anyone, as long as you're willing to truly listen to what we're saying and practice in the way that we're saying. A month. God, this guy just makes me so proud. I mean, he's not the only one. I know of two others right off the top of my head who have done the exact same thing and blown the doors off the courtroom. Kaboom, just like this. These judges have nothing. They're being exposed for exactly what they are. Yeah, this little section of video here, this whole hearing, by the way, parts 1 through 8, or maybe 9, by the time I get done editing, they are for Judge Gaston in the Portland, Oregon area. And at this point, that's all the information I'll release. Not even a picture, Judge Gaston, who tolerates prosecutors, who tattletale to you about recordings on YouTube. And then they're just so ancient, living in the 20th century, so devoid of imagination and creativity, that they can't even fathom that just maybe, because of technology, that there are, let's call them, other benefactors completely outside of even your claimed jurisdiction of no evidence having bullshit. This one's for you, Judge Gaston. I know that motherfucking prosecutor is going to tattle this tale too. And I want him to tell you this so that you maybe listen to it, Judge Gaston. Because I'm not even going close to full blast on you, Judge Gaston. As of right this moment, not even close, right? Because you were at least civil, and at least it lasted a while for you to get manipulated and embarrassed and humiliated and exposed. But you weren't violent. You never threatened violence. And so this is all it'll be for you. And that's it. And this will never talk about you again, as far as I'm concerned. I hope you grow a conscience and quit, but, you know, that's probably not going to happen. The reason why this is happening to you, Judge Gaston, though, isn't even only because of you. You're one of the nicest judges I've ever heard recorded. I never ever would have made this about you if it wasn't for Judge Johnston. So, Benjamin Johnston. I'm not even going to use the word judge with you. Benjamin Johnson? Johnston? This is all getting made for him. I'll let you know in the comments this was coming. And this is part of it. Because see, it's a new day with the internet. We don't have to use your assistant to counsel, okay? We can get our own assistants with counsel, and you won't even know a thing. And people in your court, your quote-unquote defendants, as you call them, they're not even responsible. They don't even have a damn thing to do with it. They don't even know who's recording. They don't even know if a person is in there actually recording, or if they just planted a bug earlier and are going to pick it up later. or if that person who even did it was just bribed by a benefactor from God knows where on the planet. Do you get what I'm saying? You can't automatically jump to the conclusion that your quote-unquote defendant here is guilty of recording something against your, ooh, order, big deal, ooh, scary, ooh, your opinion, ooh. That's the 21st century. That's equality bouncing back. And that's the fair and meaningful hearing that you won't allow. It doesn't matter how high you all build your wall, we're gonna find a way over it, or some other way past it. And if I have to go barreling right through the goddamn middle of it, so be it. But that's hilarious. Twice now, the prosecutor's tattletale about YouTube. Okay? Don't let him make any more wild accusations unless he's got evidence. I know that's a foreign concept, y'all. But just like jurisdiction, you're supposed to have evidence before you can even waste the court's time on accusing him again of something that he did not do. That he may or may not have done. How would you know? You don't have anything but your anger and your bitterness, because now, for the first time ever, technology's catching up with your bullshit career, and you're being exposed for what you are. Gangsters in black robes, stealing people's money, taking their kids, jailing them. Without a fair and meaningful hearing in the world. Not a presumption of innocence in the world. Not an understanding of nature and cause of the charges and proceedings against them. You accept uninformed pleas every day of your life. And you just better hope that something crazy doesn't happen to the whole country in 10 or 20 years. Because you can't erase these files. You can't burn them before the army reaches the headquarters anymore. It's out. It's a different day. And you judges need to know that we don't even have to shoot anything or get violent with you whatsoever. We don't have to. We've got the technology to expose you. You're a religion hidden in your black robes, and I do not believe it. What up, YouTube? Sunday morning, April 10th. And doing part 5 here of Heroes Hearing. And I've got good news. We're going to do a little, well, not interview, but just I'm going to record a conversation with this guy. And he's going to tell the story from his own lips about his last hearing. And it's beyond shocking. It's incredible. And we're going to learn a lot here going through it all. So here is part 5, picking up right where part 4 left off. Here we go.
Challenge might be, but I find that this court has jurisdiction over these charges.
And would you mind explaining where you find that, or how you found it, what evidence you're using to substantiate that?
Perfect response. The judge says no.
I don't want to explain any further than I have a number of times now, and that is.
I don't want to explain any further than I have a number of times now. You haven't explained once exactly what he asked. On what basis are you drawing your opinion and attempting to fine and punish me for it? You're doing it without evidence. And the judge's response is, I don't want to have to anymore. He knows he's gonna, oh shit.
Yeah, because you are charged with criminal offenses that are alleged to have occurred in this county.
So he's saying he's not going to explain. And he doesn't want to do it any more than he already has, even though he hasn't. Because the guy's got accused of something. On some territory. That he claims. For his own jurisdiction. Is that a reason? That's not even close to a reason. This is so far out of bounds from anything that could be considered actually responsive. This is just a polite dictation. A punished and a punisher. And There's no other way to, there's no way to sugarcoat that. That's exactly what this judge is doing.
You're subject to the jurisdiction of this court by...
Because I say so.
State law.
Because state law says so. States don't exist. They're imaginary. They're on paper only.
Clarification, who do you represent in this matter?
Ah, yeah, that's right. This is where he went. Who do you represent in this matter? So this is where part four left off. So here we go with new stuff.
I don't represent anyone. I'm with the circuit court.
I'm with the circuit court. I don't represent anyone. Okay, well, he didn't ask who you were with, because that doesn't mean a thing. Who you say you're with. That doesn't have any standing or bearing whatsoever, that word. So, you're just saying you don't represent anyone? Okay, well, that's great. If you don't represent anyone, including yourself, what are you doing here? Can you please go away so I can go home and you cannot threaten me anymore?
I don't represent either of the parties, either the state or you.
Well, that's stating the obvious.
Are you...
I mean, other than he does represent the prosecution, because... State of blank pays both of them and licenses both of them.
Paid by the state?
Yes, by the judicial department.
So you received your paycheck from the state of Oregon?
This is not a question and answer session for me and my employment.
Oh, I see. So you receive your pay from the state of Oregon, which is the same, you know, label that issues the licenses to the prosecution, and it's the same label as the party that is prosecuting him. And so now the judge knows this is damaging to the transcript and that shows the conflict of interest and bias. And so what does he do? He just refuses to talk about it anymore.
You've got a decision to make about...
I'm not going to answer this isn't about my employment anymore. You've got a decision to make about blah, blah, blah. It's basically saying, how do you plead? These are your choices and I'm forcing you to make one. I'm going to force you to make a claim and then punish you for it.
Whether you want to...
I'm not asking questions. I'm attempting to clarify.
Okay, I'm not answering any more questions.
I'm not asking questions. I'm just looking to clarify what you said so that I can understand it, so I can answer it accurately. Anything less would be lazy. It would be shirking a duty. Okay, if you are making a claim and part of it is vague. I am going to clarify that vagueness so that I can answer truthfully, yes or no. After all, y'all are forcing me to answer here, right? Because if I don't say anything, you're just going to punish me in silence, right?
I'm asking the questions, and I'm at this point.
I'm asking the questions, and this is going to go down my path, and This judge is supposed to be an independent, impartial third-party referee. The hero here is just simply accused of something with no evidence of jurisdiction and so far no evidence that he's actually guilty of anything. They drag him in here under threat of violence anyway. And he's just saying, no, we're going down my path.
I've given enough information, I think, to inform you about the nature of the proceedings.
Oh, you think, your opinion, you've given me enough information, you think, to inform the nature and cause. Oh, uh-huh. So you're doing your own interpretation of nature and cause. You know damn well the prosecution doesn't have evidence of jurisdiction, and that's a critical element of the charge, and that you've already declared him innocent, presumed innocent of the charges, and that jurisdiction is one of the elements of the charges, therefore he's innocent, presumed innocent of jurisdiction, therefore you have to have evidence showing that he's not innocent of jurisdiction. This hustle is so obvious. This line of this judge, he's making it just blatantly easy. I don't even have to interpret it. He's just clearly saying it.
My question for you is, are you prepared to make a decision about whether you want to participate in community court today?
Are you prepared to make a decision? You're trying to force him to make a claim. You should put a dress on a pig. It's still a pig.
Or in a future time.
I am not prepared to make that decision at this time because I have not been adequately informed.